Do you know, after those incidents took place in Sri Lanka almost 7 months ago, people all around the world still thinking that Sri Lanka is not 100% safe to travel yet. It's a very fair thought. But I'm here to prove that thought process is wrong. We are strongly believe that Sri Lanka is 100% safe now. So I am Master Geetanjana, the creator and your host of this Pathfinder YouTube channel. As a responsible person in Sri Lanka, I couldn't wait at home and see my country goes down very badly in all the areas. I am here to encourage all of you to come to Sri Lanka and enjoy the beauty of this gorgeous island. I wanted to scream towards the world and show the world how secure Sri Lanka is now. In my journey, I am going to show you some of most wonderful tourism destinations in Sri Lanka. Talking about travel and tourism, beaches are the most important and the gorgeous places in Sri Lanka. When it comes to the beaches in Sri Lanka, there are many, many nice beaches. And Bentota has one of most beauteous beaches. As a guy who lived in Bentota since the childhood, I thought I should start my journey from Bentota. When you are traveling in Bentota, there are many, many places that you can see. Some of them are very popular. Some of them are, you can call as hidden beauties in Bentota. Today, I am going to show you all of them. Before we start the journey, just go there and subscribe my channel and press the bell button. And we are ready to start. Bentota is a coastal town in Sri Lanka, located in the Gold District of the Southern Province, governed by an urban council. It is approximately 65 km south of Colombo and 56 km north of Gol. Bentota is situated on the southern bank of the Bentota River mouth at an elevation of 3 meters above the sea level. The name of the town is derived from a mythical story which claims a demon named Bem through the Tota or river bank. Bentota is a tourist attraction with a local airport and a handful of world-class hotels. It is a destination for water sports. Bentota also delivers an ancient art of healing called Ayurveda. Bentota is famous for its toddy production, an alcoholic beverage made out of coconut nectar. It also has a turtle hatchery located on Indro Beach. Bentota is located on the coastal of Southern Rail Line. Through Bentota Hall is only a small railway station with most trains stopping at Alungama, 2.5 kilometers north of Bentota. 300 meters passing the Bentota Bridge, there is a road to the left called Circular Road which goes around the horseshoe-shaped river. Five ancient Buddhist temples can be found along this route. Although now operating as five different temples, it is believed that these five temples had belonged to one large temple complex covering over 6 square kilometers in the past. Based on the archaeological studies, this temple complex has been found to be built by King Devanampiyatissa. According to Archaeology Department, during the reign of Polonnaruwa Kingdom, all the five temples has been under the Kalapatha Vihara.
Today I am at Kalapatha Rajamaha Vihara. It has well established history way back to the time of King Dutugemmun. In here, there are many special places, many special icons that you can see. Today, I have one of very important person in the area, known to be as the area guide of the temple and all. So, his name is Dumit. He is with me. So, he will let us know something more than we know. So, Dumit,
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit of the history of
history
the temple?
Yes. This is the most sacred place of Southern province.
All right.
This place has a written history about 2000 years, same age of Anuradhapura, was kingdom of Anuradhapura time.
Mm-hmm.
There were three main ancient temples in Sri Lanka in ancient time.
Sri Lanka.
Tissa Mahavihara temple, Anuradhapura Mahavihara temple, and Bendra temple.
So,
there are many names for this place. Mm-hmm. Chailantayatana temple, Selantarayatana temple, Galathurumula temple, Galapathivihara temple, Bendra temple. They are situated around Bentota village, five temples made by kings, ancient kings.
Right.
These are five temples situated as one map in the ancient time, but now separated.
Mm-hmm.
This place is Candian period rebuilt, because Portuguese destroyed this place in 1568 and rebuilt in English colonial period especially.
Mm-hmm.
You can see there are old temple and modern temple. This old temple, the foundation about 800 years old, this kingdom of Damodhini time, this paintings and statues about 450 years old. That modern temple, 250 years old building, they finished this work 1959.
In 1959.
So modern temple with Candian period and the artist models are there.
Mm-hmm.
With a red background, and you can see same and there. And old temple, every statues made of kingdom of Candy time, okay. Candian period.
Okay. Then we are seeing lots of rock pillars around the temple. So are they belong to that history, or they are newly replaced or something?
No, they are with history, stone hinges.
Mm-hmm.
Because there are three roofs on top of this each ground.
Mm-hmm.
There are first ground, second ground, and third ground.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a roof in the ancient time on this stone pillars. Now this place is controlling and guiding under guidance of archaeological department.
Mm-hmm.
We can't build or repair anything without their excuse.
Yes,
they are supplying everything for this temple to repair this.
Okay. I heard the specialty of this temple that has Arhat Kashyapa Thero's.
Yes, that's the main point of this place. There were no any place with the world in Mahakashyapa monks relics. No,
right.
Only here. Inside this stupa, they established and enshrined this Mahakashyapa monks truth relic, lifetime fallen truth relic.
Mm-hmm.
And inside this stupa, there is a small stupa made of stone in the king's time made stupa. And it's built on 12th century AD, more than 800 years old now. Okay. Especially King Sandhathis, King Great Parakram Pahu from Polonnaruwa, Nishankamalla King from Polonnaruwa, and Kirtisi Rajasingha, and many kings developed this temple, especially.
So it's believed to be the one of the greatest temples all time in Sri Lanka. So one final question to me.
Yes.
Can you tell me about a little bit of these ancient Buddha statues and the paintings?
Paintings, yes.
Also about the Perahara ceremony.
Perahara.
I heard that you are doing it annually.
Mm, yes,
so can you tell a little bit of that Perahara as well?
The statues of the old temple is same with Candian period. You can see same figures in Golden Rock of Tambulla. Same time, that's when you can see the features of the statues you can see. And paintings about Lord Buddha's reincarnation, many pictures about that, many Buddhas have given recommendation for him, you will become Buddha in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And the Prince Siddhartha's life story.
Mm-hmm.
Then Lord Buddha's character with 45 years, and we can see many paintings about his lifestyle and about his special items of his lifetime.
Okay.
Yes.
About
the Perahara festival, we are annually running this Perahara festival. It's the second biggest Perahara festival in Sri Lanka. The first one is Candy Perahara, and but this place maintaining poorly. And I hope you will visit this place and enjoy with looking at our historical place.
Yes.
Yes.
So that's it from us today from the temple. So thank you very much, Dumit, once again.
Thank you.
Giving us very valuable comments about this place. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bentota River has many branch rivers, and Deddu River is one of most eye-catching one. After pass the Deddu River for around 2 kilometers to the south, you can see the entrance of Lonuganga State. The state was the country home of the famous Sri Lankan architect Jeffrey Bawa, started in 1947. This state is facing to the Deddu River, and when you see it from the riverside, you will feel you're really looking at a heaven on earth. This wonderful place is now open to the public, and now it's running as a country house hotel. Bentota River Safari is one of the most popular outdoor activities in Bentota. It is the best way to explore the nature while enjoying a boat trip. This is ideal for all age groups. Bentota River Safari is a 2-hour journey in the boat while witnessing Bentota Lagoon, all mangroves and animals such as crocodiles, water monitors, some birds and many more.
Berula Harbour, one of main fishery harbours in western coast of Sri Lanka. It's situated in Kalutara district. More importantly, it's just 5 kilometers away from Bentota. If you are a person who love to come Bentota, and if you love to learn something new, you can come here and learn something new.
Berula Fishery Harbour is situated in the Kalutara district, bordering to the southern end of Western Province. Coastal stretch at Berula is a naturally protected area used by merchant vessels for hundreds of years as a port. The custom located close to the present harbour confirmed that this place had been used as a port even during the British rule in Sri Lanka. Ceylon Fisheries Corporation, who was responsible for providing infrastructure facilities for fishermen, initially constructed the fishery harbour in Berula in 1965. Since 1972, responsibility of maintaining and operating the harbour was entrusted to the Ceylon Fishery Harbours Corporation. This harbour is being developed as a model harbour with European Union standard facilities. The fishery harbour was destroyed during the tsunami and reconstructed by CFHC, Awakening of Fishery Harbour Project. Thank you. Barbarian Island Lighthouse is located at the town of Beruvala, which is around 5 kilometers away from Bentota on the southwestern coast of the Sri Lanka. The lighthouse here, also called the Beruvala Lighthouse, it's a massive tower about 112 feet in height. It's a white conical granite tower. It is now a tourist attraction and it helps to draw in a massive number of people. Barbarian is now of the 4 international lighthouses in Sri Lanka. This construction was completed in 1889 under the patronage of the Imperial Lighthouse Service. It can be called a landmark from Sri Lanka history from the latter stages of the colonial era. Kandy Viharaya, located within easy reach of Bentota. The Buddha statue is 160 feet tall. The temple has a library, museum, and a few devalas within itself. These were all additions made during the years after its initial establishment. Though many architectural changes have been made to the Kandy Viharaya, its ground remained the same from the ancient days. Kandy Viharaya. It has got its name because this temple is built on a mountain. This is one of major Buddhist temple in Kalpur district. As a massive temple, it has many more specialities. Buddha stupa, Dhatu Mandira, museum, and many more. And there are many more devalayas as well. Katragama Devalaya, Vishnu Devalaya, Pattini Devalaya are most notable ones. Bodhimalu Raja Mahavihara has been built during the time of King Saddhartha by the minister Devapati Raja. The original Bodhi tree and the image house of Bodhimalu Vihara had fortunately escaped the Portuguese destruction and can be still seen. The image house of this temple is also unique. In here, generally, you will find statues of Sariyut and Mughalan Terrors beside the statue of Lord Buddha. However, beside the huge seated Buddha statue at Bodhimalu Viharaya, you find two 18 cubit high statues of the deities of Vishnu and Katragama. It has been reported in 2017 that the building and the murals are decaying due to lack of maintenance by the authorities. The Vanavasi Rajamaha Viharaya is located on a rocky hill up to 150 feet above the sea level. After facing destruction and looting during the Dutch and Portuguese occupations, today Vanavasi Rajamaha Viharaya is a normal Buddhist temple in all aspects. But the uniqueness of this temple is this tunnel, which now has been excavated and restored to an extent. As we know, there are five ancient temples in Bentota. It was believed to be these five temples are connected through underground tunnels. But there were no proofs until someone tried to clear garbage pit at Vanavasa Rajamaha Viharaya, then it was exposed the open of the tunnel. Somehow, after the constructions, the tunnel has been cleared up to about 20 to 30 feet. It was believed to be this temple was destroyed by Portuguese, and this temple was rediscovered after hundreds of years in 1834 and had been reconstructed. During the Portuguese occupation of the Low Country, Bemvehta Gane Rajamaha Viharaya too faced the same fate of all other Buddhist temples in the coastal area. Demolished and looted of all valuables by the Portuguese, this temple stayed hidden inside the jungle until it was rediscovered around 200 years ago. Even after the destructions by the Portuguese, the ancient body of the Bemvehta Gane Rajamaha Viharaya survives today. This body lies on a small hill, and you can see the remains of a tunnel once connected all five temples below the tree. Today, the Bemvehta Gane Rajamaha Viharaya is more popular for its Kandy Kumara Devalaya and Sunyam Devalaya. Turtle hatcheries are good for the environment, save lives, and incredibly fun. There are few lovely ones down the coast, especially in and around the Bentota area. There are many sea turtle conservation projects in the area. They have a great sustainability model and very friendly staffs. The places are run by the locals with international volunteers helping out throughout the year.
With that, it looks like the first episode of our journey has come to the end. I really hope you enjoy the video. I am still saying my country is super secure now. Please come here and enjoy the beauty of Sri Lanka. If you have any doubt or if you have to add something or if you have to know something else, please feel free to leave a comment and I really would love to reply them all. Remember, your comments and your thoughts are my value and my strength. Like my video, subscribe my channel, press the bell button, and more importantly, keep in touch with me. I hope to meet you again with another gorgeous destination in Sri Lanka as soon as possible. I am Master Geetanjana, signing off with my camera expert and my partner Gayan Gunasekara. Until then, Pathfinder says goodbye and take care.